Assalamu alaikum. I'm Dr. Muhammad Mohsin. Today we will talk about another station of procedures, which is male catheterization. As we know, we have three types of stations of procedures in the exam. The first type is an actor plus a maquette. And the second type is only a maquette, and the third is only one station, which is operative list arrangement. So we will start with male catheterization station, which is the fifth station and the last one under the first type. The stem of this station will be you are requested to insert a Foley's catheter. Also consider that, as we said before, you may be requested to wear an apron before you enter the station. So please notice the instruction and read it very carefully. You will find inside the station a pelvis maquette. Okay, the actor will wear something like a pelvis maquette, including genital organs attached to the actor's pelvis and covered by a towel to preserve the patient dignity. As we went through in the last stations, we will start as usual with our 10 steps. As usual, we consider identify yourself. So I'm Dr. Muhammad Mohsin, one of the examination candidates, and then confirmation of the patient name and age. May I confirm your name and age, please? And then explanation. Explain the procedure to the patient. I'm going to insert a plastic tube through your urinary passage to drain the collected urine. To drain the collected urine in your bladder. This will be done under local anesthesia. Typically, you will not feel pain, but you may have some discomfort during the insertion of the tube. If you have unbearable pain at any time, please tell me to stop. So now you have explained the procedure, and you should explain all of the procedure in layman language. Try not to use medical terms. Then after that, you have to gain verbal consent. May I proceed with that? And after you finish with that with the patient, you have to tell the examiner, now I have to check the patient notes for the presence of a written consent. Is that available? And the examiner will tell you yes, already consent was taken, or consider it taken, or consider it signed. Okay, and the fifth thing will be as usual, WHO checklist. In WHO checklist, we examine the hand bracelet of the patient to check the name written and compare it with the patient name that he told us about. Also ask about or confirm the correct procedure. I'm going to insert a Foley's catheter, and of course no site here, no site here. Also, you have to confirm that the patient doesn't take any medication. Have you do you have any medication, especially blood thinner? And ask also about allergy. Do you have any allergy? Before you prepare your equipment, there is a hemodynamic chart present in the station. You have to check it. Okay, it will be present in the stem to check the patient fluid chart, and also you will find all vital signs inside this chart are normal. The patient is not hypotensive, not toxic, not hypovolemic, and usually an assistant will be available in this station. So you have to, after you finish WHO checklist, this chart, you have to check it, okay, before you proceed. And then you have to prepare, your equipment. Ask the assistant in the station to bring your equipment to you. Ask him to bring gauze at least two for drabbing the penis of the patient. Also forceps for drabbing, sterilizing agent, and most probably it is not available in the station, and the examiner will say consider saline is a sterilizing agent. Also ask him to bring an acetic gel or any Stella gel present inside 10 ml syringe. Ask him to prepare 10 ml syringe plus 10 ml saline for fixing the catheter by infiltrating its balloon. Also ask him to prepare a full catheter. You will find as usual different sizes of full catheter, but better to use size number 14. It is easy to handle and appropriate for insertion in the exam. Also, you have to prepare kidney dish for collecting urine, as no urine bag available inside the station. And also sterile gloves. You have to prepare sterile gloves. Okay, so you have to write and memorize these tools, and you have to memorize them inside the station. After that, we will come to the procedure itself. The procedure will be we will use what we call a dirty hand clean hand technique. In this technique, one hand will catch the penis, and this will be the dirty hand, and the other one will be or the dominant hand will be the clean hand, which insert the catheter inside the penis. There are many different techniques like double glove technique and other techniques, but most of them are time consuming. So I think this is better for you in the exam because it will save some time. How we will proceed with this technique? You will catch the left hand. And as I said, we will consider it the dirty hand. It will grasp the penis all the time. So you will not use it in catheter insertion. The right hand, which is your dominant hand, will be the clean one. you will use it for insertion of the catheter. So first uncover the towel over the pelvis. You will take a gauze by the forceps and with your right hand soaked with sterilizing agent, and then grasp the penis with your left hand and drab the gland's penis. Take a note that sometimes the penis is not circumcised. Okay, the penis sometimes is not circumcised, and you have to retract the foreskin a little bit to expose the glands by your left hand. So you have to do this step first. Then drab the glands in a circular method, and then discard the gauze in the yellow bag. Then take another gauze with the forceps and soak it in the sterilizing agent, and then drab the meatus of the urethra, and then throw it in the yellow bag. Now you will tell the patient that you will inject the local anesthetic gel into the meatus. You have to tell him, I'm going to inject the anesthetic gel inside your urinary passage. Typically this will make you feel some discomfort, and you have to take verbal consent from him. Can I proceed with that? Usually he will accept yes. After injection of the local anesthesia, you have to tell the examiner as usual, I have to wait for 5 minutes till the action of the local anesthesia, and then complete, because of course in the exam you can't wait for 5 minutes. After that, ask the assistant to give you the urinary catheters, and as we said before, we will use size number 14. And then open the cover in a sterile way and remove the tip of the inside plastic cover of the catheter to expose the tip of the catheter. Insert the catheter slowly with your right hand and grasp the penis over the catheter with your left hand to prevent it from coming out again. Then when you find some resistance or some obstacles in insertion, change the direction of the penis upwards and backwards. So your change of this direction upwards and backwards, like facing the patient face, this will straighten the urethra, and then you can continue insertion till the bifurcation of the catheter. If there is still fluid inside the urinary bladder of the maquette, it will flow outside the catheter, because sometimes with successive stations, the fluid inside the maquette decreases much, or maybe not present. So you have to take care of this point. Then you will find, as we said, flow outside the catheter. Now put a kidney dish between the patient legs to collect urine. If no urine comes out, if the maquette, as we said, is empty, the examiner may ask you, consider there is, may tell you, consider there is urine coming out. Ask the assistant to give you a saline syringe to fix the catheter by inflating the balloon. Also take a note that you have not to forget to return the foreskin over the glands and cover the patient again with the towel to preserve the patient dignity. This is very important step in this station. Okay, and after that we finished the procedure. We'll come to as usual to disposal. In disposal, we directly discard everything after we finish. Syringe, gloves, gauze, all will be discarded in the yellow bag. And then you have to give the patient some instructions. What instruction you will give to the patient? You will tell him, I have inserted a plastic tube inside your urinary passage. Typically, the urine will come through it to a collecting urinary bag. You have to be cautious during your movement. You have to inform the nurse if you have any unbearable pain or if you have a tummy pain. And then you have to offer documentation of the procedure. Ask the examiner, now I have to document the procedure in the patient notes. Okay, so this is the last step. Now we will come to questions. After you finish the station, the examiner will ask you some questions. First, he will ask you, what will you do if no urine drains after catheterization? The answer of these questions, you will tell him, I have to reevaluate the presence of urine in urinary bladder by percussing the suprapubic region for dullness, and if I didn't do it before, request ultrasound bladder scan to check the presence of urine inside the urinary bladder. So first examination, and then ultrasound of the urinary bladder. Also, you will tell him that I can apply some suprapubic pressure. You can aspirate with a 50 ml syringe or flush the catheter using 50 ml syringe and saline, because sometimes the gel plug prevent the urine from coming out. The other question, or the second question, will be, you did all these maneuvers and still no urine comes out. What may be the cause? Then you will tell the examiner that the patient may have no urine due to renal failure. So the next question will be directly, what are the causes of renal failure? And as we know, the causes of renal failure is divided into main three types. Either pre-renal or renal or post-renal. The pre-renal, like dehydration or hypovolemia, renal, like acute tubular necrosis or bilateral renal cysts, example polycystic kidney disease, and renal parenchymal disease, and post renal, like stone obstructing the urethra and the urinary passage. So the next question the examiner will ask you, you inserted a urinary catheter and no urine came out. and then you removed the catheter. Afterwards, you palpated the abdomen and found a suprapubic mass. What's your differential diagnosis? So the question is differential diagnosis of a suprapubic mass. So my differential diagnosis will be urinary bladder fold of urine and wasn't probably catheterized. Number two, colon cancer, and the third differential diagnosis is large iliac artery aneurysm. These are all about this station, and this is the last station of the type number one of the procedures. I hope this was beneficial to you. Good luck and thank you.